Hi everyone. In this video, we will explain about the tax proof submission module.
This module has 5 steps that you must complete in order to make the tax proof submissions. You can submit or edit the tax proofs up to a maximum of 3 times, after which you will not be able to edit the submissions.
This blue icon, which is available in all the pages, will give you details about the maximum limit under each section.
The first step consists of 2 sections, the house rent allowance and the children education allowance. In the house rent allowance, enter the rent paid per month, the duration of rent paid, the city and the landlord details. Below the declaration is a space where you can upload the supporting documents. You can either download the pre-filled document from here, fill it up and submit it, or you can submit the existing documents that you have. If the documents that you submit are password protected, enter the password of the files here and click upload button.
Below this, under children education allowance section, enter the number of children who are going to school and the number of children who are staying in hostel. After giving the proof submissions for both the sections, click save and continue to go to the second step.
The second step contains submissions with respect to house property. If you have taken a loan for a self-occupied property, click this option and enter the details of the property and the loan taken. In case if you want to take additional exemption under section 80EE or EEEA, click the S option here and select the financial year in which the loan was taken. This exemption can be claimed only when certain conditions are met. The conditions are mentioned here. Click on this checkbox if they are applicable. If not, select the option no here. Below this is where you have to enter the lender details, after which is the co-borrower details. If you have a co-borrower for the loan, enter the percentage of share on housing loan that you want to claim for tax exemption here. Below this is where you have to upload the supporting documents. In case of loan on let out property, click this option and enter the rental income received from this property, the address and the tax paid for this property, and also the lender details. After providing all these details, click save and continue to go to the third step.
In the third step, you can declare and submit the tax proofs for the various investments made in tax saving instruments. Once you enter the values here, you can find the actual declarations made here and the qualifying amount here. Below is where you have to upload the supporting documents. Below this is the space where you have to make future declaration. For example, if you have an insurance policy for which the premium is in a future date, click this option and enter the policy details here. Click save and continue to go to the next step.
The fourth step is investment under other sections. That is 80D. For self and family, you can claim the medical insurance here, and cost preventive health checkup can be claimed here. And for dependent parents, you can claim the medical insurance here. And if your parents are senior citizens, you have to enable the checkbox. If your parents are senior citizens, you can either claim medical insurance or medical expenses. You cannot claim both together. And it is mandatory to enable the checkbox of self-declaration. And below that, you can upload the supporting documents. So the next is exemption under other sections of 6A. You can enter the amount here. Once you enter the amount, the option to upload the documents will be enabled. So you can upload the supporting documents here. So if you're claiming for 80DDB, you have to enter the amount and enable the self-declaration checkbox. And you can click save and continue to go to the next page. The fifth step is previous employer income. You can upload the tax computation report that you have received from the previous employer. And please note that only if you enter the amount here, the upload option will be enabled. The next is income from other sources. You can enter the amount here. The next is family declaration. You can enter the details of your family members here. At last, it is self-declaration. You have to enable the checkbox to submit it. Once you submit it, you will receive a confirmation mail with the details you have provided. If you have any further queries, you can contact p.support@relativity.co.in to clear your queries. We are happy to help you. Thank you.